Hi, in this episode of Healing 101, we're talking about the five signs of false faith healers. Improperly interpreting a scripture or two from Isaiah doesn't make one a false faith healer. Like any other New Testament ministry, truth or falsehood is determined by adherence to the Great Commission. Are they making disciples for Jesus? Are they baptizing and teaching people to obey everything Jesus commanded? Or does their ministry or character give evidence of other motives? Deceivers can be masters of the smoke and mirrors. So here are the five signs of false faith healers. 1. Most of their material points to themselves rather than to Jesus. Testimonies, encouragements, and the purported path to healing focus on the humans running the enterprise rather than on Jesus. 2.
Shout Jesus from the mountains and Jesus in the streets. Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name.
Most scripture references are taken out of context in a way to point to their own healing ministry rather than to Jesus or to clear New Testament discipleship goals. 3. The third sign of false faith healers. Rather than depend on the Lord for their financial support, there is some kind of quid pro quo for ministry services, explicit assertions of God's healing in exchange for financial remuneration. 4. Healing is the purported goal, rather than becoming more and more like Jesus. In these cases, there's little concern for sin, for repenting of ongoing sins, or for addressing the sins that may have contributed to our ongoing health or discipleship challenges. 5. The fifth sign of a false faith healer. Their material points to stronger reliance on their ministry rather than growing to independence in Jesus. Real ministers of Jesus make disciples who make disciples and strive to work to move those we serve to reduce dependence on human ministries and greater dependence on our Lord Jesus.
There's a long black train coming down the line.
Hey man, how's it going?
I've messed everything up. Flunked out of school, my girl dumped me. No one wants to hire me because the drug thing.
Feeding off the souls that are lost and crying.
You ask Jesus for help?
What's the point? Maybe it's time to unburden everyone from my crap.
A year ago, I was like a deer in the headlights. Whenever I wondered if a friend was contemplating suicide, my ministry training had not prepared me to handle these crisis encounters. Then I took a suicide prevention course from E94 with Justin Pallison. This 90-minute course taught us how to recognize the warning signs, gently ask some direct questions, persuade people in crisis not to take irreversible actions, and confidently refer them to one of the free and widely available resources to move them from crisis to lasting recovery. Justin is a qualified, gifted, and skilled teacher. He's the right man at the right time to bring this training to you and your church. This training is free and can be provided in person in North Georgia, and virtual training is available anywhere in the world. Visit their website at e94.org for more information.
Cling to the Father and His holy name, and don't go riding on that long black train.
The good life is the land where the big grapes grow, milk and honey flow, from the morning till the night, and everybody singing to Jesus. Yeah, the good life is the land where the big grapes grow, milk and honey flow, from the morning till the night, and everybody singing to Jesus. Oh, I love Jesus.